7 years ago, the city of Amsterdam decided to close its 28 bridge engineers' houses, from which individual bridge controllers put the bridges up and down as ships pass through. They decided to centralize that and run all the bridges by camera digitally from one central location. Susanne Oxenaar, who was the person behind the Lloyd Hotel here in Amsterdam, suddenly had the idea, wouldn't these bridge engineers' houses be wonderful hotel rooms? It's taken 7 years and a huge amount of doing, but she's done it, and today the bridge engineers' houses are opening.
Okay, here we are.
Sun, that makes my hair.
Put my head for
the sun. It's really bright, yeah.
A bright day. Good day to celebrate finishing the bridge
watchers' houses,
bridge managers' houses. I'm sure there's a bridge engineers' houses.
Yes, yeah. It's like, after 7 years, it's not as long as the Lloyd Hotel, which was called Never Hotel, which is in Dutch like
the Nooit Hotel.
So I'm very glad. We're opening now the first 11, which means 17
many?
More to come.
17 more to come. So 28 of these little houses all together.
Now we are in one of the more modern one of the 80s, but the oldest one is from 1672. So each time again, and you can see that here, we work together with Space and Matter Architects. Mm-hmm. We try to see like what is in this house already that gives an idea, a start to change it into a place to also sleep. And here they use the materials. It's aluminium. It's in a way kind of cheap material that you find here. One of the things that's very important for a hotel room is that people want to be completely dark at night. Now
yes.
You see the bridge watchers' houses
glass on
are
all
opposite.
Sides.
It's glass. Yeah. So they made a very inventive thing. And suddenly you have a little tent, you can sit here and you have your own privacy.
We started the idea that on all little vacant spots in the city you could actually make architectural sweet spots. In the beginning, the bridge houses were placed on the bridge. Later in time, they were placed besides the bridge, and the latest bridge houses that were built were placed in the water next to the bridge because traffic needed more and more space. So that's how they tell a little bit about how Amsterdam grew.
Leave it to Susanne Oxenaar to make a theatrical event out of the opening of the first batch of bridgekeepers' houses that have been converted into hotel rooms. In one there was a DJ playing, in another there was a guitarist. In one of the other houses, two cute girls were lying in bed watching something on their laptop. It was really fun. It's interesting too, the way these bridgekeepers' houses have been given a new function is an example of adaptive reuse that you have never seen before. It's a great way to spread tourism across the city and also to open up the city's history. I think many of us, certainly myself, have biked past these little houses a million times and never really stopped to look or to think. And now I have. This project is great fun.
Exactly, yes, okay. And the future tourists who are gonna come here, and I'm glad to be the first.